Hi folks, this is David Kwan here. I feel like I'm at a video blog lag time, because it's like I meant to be talking about this in front of a camera quite some time ago when I was in Washington D.C. But like it just, you know, I just wasn't in the mood for it, I suppose, or something or the other. So I'm talking about it now a week later. But I was in Washington D.C. For a course. It was a school related thing. But it was a pretty interesting experience, and I was there just to kind of learn. The course title is called Social Work and Legislative Advocacy. I think that's the order. Sometimes I think it's Legislative Advocacy and Social Work. But anyway, that doesn't matter. The purpose of the course is to learn how to really be, you know, to be a social worker, but at the same time be more politically involved and advocate on behalf of the clients that we serve, the organizations that we want to improve to provide necessary social services as social workers, you know. And so it was a pretty, like, I was really interested in the course in many ways because of the kind of the internship that I have currently, which I can't talk about until I graduate. But because of that too, and but also because, you know, it's like thinking about kind of how systems at large and policies at large, both at the federal level and the state level, and especially the local level, and levels that are even tinier than that, you know, like at an institutional level. So if I was working in a nonprofit organization, the policies of that organization affect the work that I do. But that organization, the policies that the organization has is in some ways that way because of the laws of New York City or the policies of New York City. And that policies in some ways has to be that way because of the funding policies that come from the New York State Legislature and also with competing city agencies and city governments, what have you. But that also is determined completely, largely dependent on the kind of the actions that, or the inactions, or the discussions, or whatever happens at a federal level in Congress, in United States Supreme Court, and of course by the presidential administration. So it's very important to think about. And so, like, a way to affect or influence these kind of systems as a social service worker or human service worker is extremely crucial, because if the leaders that are not human social workers dictate what happens in these in Congress, in state, in local government that fund organizations that social services workers will work in, and these organizations are usually not led by social workers but people who don't have a background in social work, people with business degrees, people with public administration degrees. But, you know, I think public administration in some ways is a worthwhile degree in the sense that, you know, it's a public service-oriented training and education. But it's still, there's many other kinds of people that just kind of come in and take the leadership roles. Not to say there's anything totally wrong with that, but the problem is they do not understand what it is. That's what they may not understand. It's likely that they don't. Really what's actually necessary on the ground at the front lines of providing social services. So I was in Washington D.C. for a course in regards to that. Just that topic alone is something that social work students are not very exposed to. So just being in an academic setting where that kind of discussion is happening, where that kind of learning is happening, is really cool. But the course itself was really was a pretty powerful course, because every lecture was done with a guest speaker, and these guest speakers were very qualified individuals in some sense, and all kind of had various backgrounds. Here we met someone with a neuroscience background, who was a researcher. We met somebody who has a social work background, but he actually had a very similar background, like personal life background to me. You know, his father was a pastor. He thought he was going to train to be just like his father and be a pastor himself, kind of like me, but ended up deciding that, you know, Christianity was not his calling and being a pastor was not his calling, and ended up being a social worker instead, kind of like me. So except I'm not a social worker yet. I'm just a social work student. So pretty interesting. And so he was more in the working in the background of politics and working, you know, meeting with legislators and politicians and supporting caucuses and whatnot. So that was that person. It was just fantastic. Like just all these guest speakers who just had such ideas. But the best learning experience for me in this course was actually just kind of doing the practice work of what political advocacy is like. And so I'm probably going to make more videos from what I've learned about this course, but I just kind of wanted to I really wanted to do this video when I was in Washington, D.C. and say, hey guys, I'm in Washington, D.C. Check this out. This is what I'm here for about. But that ship has sailed, and now here I'm back in here in my crabby looking apartment here. But this is how New Yorkers, some of us, live here. But yeah, it was fascinating. But just actually working, we were split into four different groups. Each group had its own dynamic, and I thought it was very interesting how our group ended up being very similar to kind of my role in my internship. You know, in my internship, I am an intern on behalf of a very powerful person, executive in the agency. So this person is a leader, you know, and so my role is to kind of represent that leader and to kind of translate the leader's vision to other group members who are also leaders in themselves. You know, I'm an intern, but I'm surrounded by these super powerful individuals in my internship. And I communicate with them, and then there's this project I'm working in my internship that has me more involved with the lesser powerful people, and that's probably been the best experience for me because I really have more great conversations with people at those levels than the higher level people. But the extremely high level people are amazing. I have a tendency to kind of have more in conflict with the middle managers, but that's neither here nor there. I can't really talk about that here. It's not really a conflict. It's a very bad picture. You know, I get along with everyone, but there are some challenges here and there with what we want to achieve and and everyone has different opinions about that. But the group dynamic that I had, it was really great. I think I was really fortunate to be in the group that I was in. As the only guy in the group, I also was trying to be very mindful of how I was presenting myself. You know, I don't want to be overbearing or kind of being seen like, I didn't want to be like too much like a leader. So I was really hoping that like in this group, you know, kind of somebody kind of rises up to kind of take charge. I mean, that didn't necessarily happen. Everyone was fantastic in the group, and everyone did. What I was really amazed by was everyone kind of had their own role that they were really good at, and everyone kind of like, I want to do. And there was this one instance where we were kind of figuring out the roles, and I just waited out. I knew what I wanted to do, but I just kind of waited and was hoping, you know, like, and see what would happen. And after everyone kind of was like, I'm gonna do this. The only thing that was left was what I wanted to do. I thought that was pretty amazing. But there were some parts where it felt like I was doing my internship, like representing on the leader of the organization and kind of helping the others kind of follow up to that vision of the leader. That actually happened in this group dynamic once. I was like, whoa. So I don't know if that's because that's what I'm more used to now in the internship or whatever. But definitely learning how to work in group projects is this is a very great learning experience because I'm with fellow students. They're all my level. There is no like crazy hierarchy, but that's also what made it a bit more complicated. The internship that I have is very hierarchical, so it's very easy to understand. Okay, so you are this position, you do this role, right? And this one is a bit more murkier. Like I'm a student just like you, so. You know, there's more kind of negotiating and kind of collaborating in some ways what to do. So that was interesting. And I'm not very good with small talk. Like I said, that's always my weak point. You know, I'm kind of socially awkward in many ways in these kind of settings. So trying to get that is pretty interesting. But I definitely learned a lot from kind of working in a group like that. So that, to me, I said that's what I was most excited to kind of learn about, to work in a group, to really kind of go as a group to meet with, we actually met, not our group, but all our groups went to Capitol Hill, and we really legislatively advocated for an issue, for a bill, for a campaign that we had. We went there and we talked to legislators. In our case, in our group, we actually talked to the legislator, but we talked to the congresswoman's aide, like their policy advisor and their staff advisor. So we met with them at Capitol Hill, and we that's what we prepared for as a group as well too. We prepared for two things, but you know, doing that was an incredible experience. And there's been talk around the class is like, oh, this should be a mandatory class for social work students. And, you know, that's an amazing idea. Logistically speaking, I don't know how that's going to work. But after the course, I did send an email out to the curriculum, the dean of the curriculum, the dean who decides how the curriculum is kind of taught in my school, in NYU. So emailed her about it. Haven't really heard a reply. I don't think I'll get any reply. But I actually did email her like, hey, this is what I think should be, these are my ideas on how to kind of improve the curriculum of the school, considering that now I've experienced this course, which is quite so different from all the other courses, but so really important as social workers. Learning how to navigate the world of policy and laws and politics, and doing advocacy around that part, I think is really important. And this is a week-long course, but even so, there were a lot of things that the course didn't really delve into. And one of the emails that I was having back and forth with the course instructor was like, after the course was over, yeah, we didn't really talk about like phone banking, you know, advocating with kind of the phone outreach campaigns that way. And that way, we didn't talk about phone banking. We didn't talk about kind of the community organizing that can happen. There's so many, you know, layers and layers of content that can be talked about this issue of social workers making a change at a political and a legislative level. So being at Washington D.C. was pretty cool in regards to that. It's already 12 minutes. That's I talk so much in these videos. My videos end up being so long. I don't know why. That's not even what I really wanted to talk about in this video anyway. But anyway, the fact is, I just had a course like that. It was really cool. There are a lot of good takeaways from this course that I'll probably make into a different video. Yeah, long time coming. I'm finally back to being more regular with my blog thingy. Yeah, if you guys enjoy it, cheers.